step would be like, how do I actually do a quiet time? The first rule in this accepted science of quiet time is slow down. Slow down. And that probably sounds obvious, but sometimes obvious things are not so obvious. You have to slow down because God is never in a hurry. And you can't hear God's voice if you're just rushing all the time. You have to slow down to hear what he wants to say to you. That's why you have to get up a little bit earlier, so you're not just rushing into your day if you don't have time. So you just find a quiet place, you grab your Bible, maybe a journal, get a cup of coffee or tea or whatever you want in the morning, and just go spend a few minutes with the Lord. Here's what Jesus said about it in Matthew 6. He said, here's what I want you to do. Just find a quiet, secluded place so you won't be tempted to role play before God. You're not going to try to put on airs or impress anybody. He says, just be there as simply and honestly as you can manage. And the focus will shift from you to God, and you will begin to sense his grace. Now, since a quiet time is a conversation with God, then you should probably let God start the conversation, because this may be news to some of you, he is God and you are not. So you probably ought to start by letting him start the conversation. You don't start with an hour of prayer. You don't start by telling him what's on your mind. Start with just a moment of prayer. A simple moment that says, Lord, here I am. I'm ready. I want to hear from you today. Would you just open my eyes, open my ears, open my heart, whatever it is you want to say.
See, everybody thinks that hearing God's voice is this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And it's this every once in a while. He only talks to you on special occasions. That's not true. He's talking to you every day. He wants to talk to you every single day. Look at the scripture in Isaiah 50. It says this. He awakens me morning by morning. He awakens my ear to listen as a disciple. God's trying to talk to you every single day. You just have to listen. You just have to listen. Either you don't know his voice, or you are too busy to listen. See, don't let the busy of your day drown out the voice of your God. Let me tell you something about busy. Busy, B-U-S-Y, being under Satan's yoke. Busy. Busyness will rob you of the ability to hear your God. Because we like to fill up our day with all these things to do. And before you know it, you go days, weeks, sometimes even months and years without hearing God's voice. And the enemy will use busy to keep you from God doing God's will and hearing his voice. See, margin is the opposite of busy. Margin says, I'm going to value my quiet time with God. It's the most important part of my day. So that's where I'm going to invest my time. You want to start your day off with quiet time. But let's be a little honest. Some of us aren't morning people. Some of us ain't morning people. It's okay. I get it. I'm not really a morning person either. So some of us has to get real creative about our quiet time. For some, maybe it's just turning off the radio on the way to work so you can spend a few minutes of silence with God. Maybe it's the first 15 minutes of your workday. Before you do anything else, I'm going to spend time just listening and praying. Or maybe at lunchtime, you eat your food a little bit faster for 15 minutes and spend the rest of your time with God. Or maybe at night, instead of binge watching 6 episodes on Netflix, you watch 5 and use that last hour to spend some time with God. Whatever it is, that's not the point. The point is, make sure you value margin enough to protect your quiet time with God. Because God absolutely wants to speak to you. He loves speaking to you. I don't know what trouble you may be facing and pain you may be feeling, but I do know this. You need to hear God's voice. And the way you're going to hear God's voice